And today I'm going to reveal 7 clinically proven ways to quickly and naturally increase your free testosterone levels. Again, no drugs. In a previous video, I discussed the difference between total and free testosterone levels. Now, one of the primary ways to increase your free testosterone is by lowering your sex hormone binding globulin, also known as SHBG. All right, for men, some of the symptoms of having high sex hormone binding globulin include decreased sexual development. This is especially in teenagers. Infertility, decreased sperm concentration and motility, decreased sex drive, obviously, impotence, reduced testicular size, also breast growth, also known as gynecomastia or bitch tits, decreased body hair, reduced bone and muscle mass, obviously, increased belly fat, and also decreased energy and motivation. As you can see, these problems are similar to just simply having low total testosterone levels or also aging. So let's quickly discuss the 7 best ways to naturally lower your sex hormone binding globulins. And I'm going to keep it really simple, nothing complicated, so you have no excuse not to take action today. Number 1 is lower your estrogen and prolactin levels. These are female hormones. Now, as estrogen levels increase, so does your sex hormone binding globulin. Again, we don't want that. Also, as estrogen levels go up, testosterone levels typically come down due to different negative feedback mechanisms in your body. Now, one of the best ways to lower your estrogen is to simply lose body fat. And this is because your fat cells produce estrogen all on their own. Fat also increases the aromatase enzyme, which converts your testosterone to estrogen. All the things we do not want. Obviously, losing body fat can be difficult and obviously takes time. So at the very least, you can also take natural supplements which will help, such as DIM, white button mushroom extract, as well as B6, more specifically P5P, which also lowers your prolactin level, a female hormone. The second thing you want to do is increase your growth hormone levels. Now, naturally increasing your GH will help lower the excess estrogen levels in numerous ways. Ironically, taking exogenous GH, hence such as injectable growth hormone, can actually increase your estrogen and prolactin levels. Honestly, the best way to increase your GH levels, if it's up to me, is to get deep quality sleep. And that means go to bed before midnight and don't wake up with an alarm. Just wake up naturally. Now, the third thing you want to do is improve liver health. Keep in mind that since sex hormone binding globulin is mainly produced in the liver, liver damage or stress can result in abnormal SHBG levels. Almost all drugs will cause stress on the liver, so keep that in mind. Obviously, so does, you know, drugs such as alcohol. So best you want to do is at least reduce drugs, all right, as much as you can, and take supplements that support liver health. My favorites that I personally take are NAC, N-acetylcysteine, milk thistle extract, and also another one called Tutka. Now, number 4, you want to eliminate drugs. As I just stated, many drugs are bad and increase your sex hormone binding globulin directly or indirectly. Indirectly, by just putting stress on the liver, as I just mentioned a minute ago. Directly would be drugs such as marijuana, alcohol, and cigarettes, and many over-the-counter drugs such as painkillers and sleeping aids. Number 5, you want to lower stress and cortisol levels. Listen, I think we all know that stress is bad for you in many ways, and this includes your sex hormone binding globulin. One primary reason for this is as stress hormones such as cortisol levels go up, so does your sex hormone binding globulin. At the same time, both your total and free testosterone levels, as well as growth hormone, come down. Again, all negative things. Obviously, we can't eliminate stress from our lives. Just know that at the very least, get better sleep, all right? Can't emphasize how important sleep is. And yes, there are very potent and natural supplements that will also help lower cortisol levels and thus increase your total and free testosterone. I've listed them below. Just one important note. You want cortisol levels to be low at night, but not during the day, all right? All hormones have pros and cons. This is why I take my cortisol lowering supplements right after my workouts, when it's really peaked up, and most importantly, before bed. About half an hour to an hour before bed, I take my cortisol lowering supplements. Now, next thing you want to do is improve your diet. Listen, diet, as with everything else, is very important. Diet affects everything. Now, when it comes to lowering sex hormone binding globulin, obviously increasing your free testosterone levels, you want to make sure you're eating enough animal protein. This is important. Animal protein, the good kind as well, such as pasture-raised and free-range red meat, eggs, and chicken. Also, wild-caught seafood, such as salmon. And again, if you don't like fish, at least make sure you take some omega-3 fish oils. That's also important for increasing your free testosterone. However, most importantly is making sure you're eating enough carbohydrates and the good kind, the good natural kind, such as fruits and vegetables, white rice, yams, and so forth. Yes, low-carb diets such as keto or carnivore do lower your free testosterone levels and thus increase your sex hormone binding globulin. Listen, here's the real deal. Carbs increase insulin, and insulin is a very powerful hormone in the right amounts, especially for lowering sex hormone binding globulin, as well as growth hormone and IGF-1. Finally, number 7, you can take specific supplements. And I've already listed some of the supplements earlier for lowering sex hormone binding globulin and increasing free testosterone levels indirectly. However, there are specific vitamins and herbs and minerals that directly work for increasing your free and total testosterone. Some of the best are boron, also zinc, which should be taken with copper, vitamin D3, which should be taken with vitamin K2, and also Tonghat Ali, herbs like testophen, horny goatweed, tribulus, fadagio, and also a couple other ones. I've listed the one supplement that I personally take in the description here that contains all of these in one pill. So as I with everything, I like it to be easy and convenient for me, and obviously cost less money when you buy everything in one pill rather than separately.